Welcome back to our Proactive London studio, and I'm joined now by Tiffany Thorn, who's the CEO of BiVictriX. And a very warm welcome to you, Tiffany.
Good morning, Tom.
So your full year results out now for 2022. Perhaps you'd like to start by giving us the highlights.
Yeah, sure. So we've had a really good year over the past 12 months. We've made really good progress across all of our business objectives. We've made great progress with the lead program, BVX001. So we nominated our development leads end of last year. We have reported recently some very positive preclinical safety results as well on that program. And then we've expanded the pipeline. So we're now targeting not just liquid tumours, but solid tumours as well. So it shows the breadth of the approach. We've strengthened our IP portfolio. We've strengthened our team and our capabilities on site. So we now retain more know-how in the company. And importantly, we've also identified a new way to nominate novel Bi-Signi fingerprints that are cancer selective. So this helps to future-proof the company and take us into new areas, new cancer types.
So Tiffany, obviously a lot going on, but is there one thing that you're particularly proud of, would you say?
I think the preclinical safety results that we announced at the end of January is a key highlight for us. So antibody drug conjugates, very effective at killing cancer cells, very well validated therapeutic class, but toxicity is still a major concern. And so what we did was we developed an animal model which encapsulates the toxicity, the bone marrow toxicity that you see in the clinic, which is life-threatening and currently limiting this therapeutic class. And we dosed our lead molecule alongside a commercial comparator, the only commercial drug ADC in acute myeloid leukemia. And whereas the commercial drug completely killed all the healthy bone marrow neutrophil cells, which is a problem in the clinic, our candidate left these unharmed. And as far as I'm aware, no other ADC company has ever generated data that's shown selectivity window of that size. So really positive data for the concept and to show that we can generate next generation ADCs with less toxicity.
Great stuff. Now, obviously, these were the results for 2022. It's almost ancient history. We're about to move into the second quarter of 2023. So what do you think people should be keeping their eyes open for in the next few months?
So we're continuing to generate more supportive data across our programs, particularly our lead programs. So there'll be hopefully some exciting further data to report in the next few months. But whilst we've got already some very compelling data to hand, we are now focused on improving the visibility of the company. We're actively talking to third parties that might have a potential interest in a collaboration or a partnership with BiVictriX. A colleague and myself recently attended BiEurope Spring in Basel last week. We had over 30 meetings with the likes of large pharma to mid-sized biotech companies already active in the ADC space or looking to move into the ADC space, all of which expressed a significant interest in next generation ADC approaches with reduced toxicity. So hopefully we are in the right place at the right time. So we'll continue to seek out those sorts of positive relationships whilst generating more data on the programs as well.
Well, we'll be keeping a close eye, Tiffany, and be getting regular updates as always. But until next time, thank you very much indeed for your time today.
Thank you, Tom.